Shares are plunging after a big earnings miss that cut the outlook. Steve Weiss owns it. That's why he's calling in. It's the first earnings miss in almost 2 years, the biggest miss in 4 years. Steve Weiss, what are you doing with this?
Well, first of all, thanks for letting me take a spot that's normally reserved for Flyer Jen to explain an underperformer. So I very much appreciate that. Look, you know, the market was telling me something. The stock specifically was telling me something. It's been trading horrendously since they reported last quarter, kept going down. Yesterday it was down, so it had its foot in my neck saying we're going to miss. I actually spoke to the company a couple of weeks ago. I've spoken to others that do the same thing, and labor is an issue. The street move was going to miss, but not this bad. This is pretty bad. What am I doing? I was going to wait to buy it because it's trading at what's an historically or near historically low multiple at around 11 times. They're raising prices across the board. And labor, I believe, is going to loosen up now that we're done with this with the summer. So I added a little bit today. I cut the position just slightly after the call or when they reported the numbers, down about $6, and quite frankly, really shocked to see it down this much. But to me, the story hasn't changed. It's only been pushed back by a quarter or so. There's only one firm that downgraded it. Goldman came out, reiterated. They're pretty good in this space. Others have as well. So I'm staying with it. I added a little today, as I said, and I'll continue to add as the stock stabilizes.
So just to make certain none of this gets lost in the shuffle, you cut your position in it yesterday. You bought a little bit back today.
Correct.
All right.
Still pretty painful. You know.
No, I hear you. I just want to make sure we're clear on that, especially since it's a phoner. Raymond James downgrades the stock to market perform. That's the downgrade you're talking about. But J.P. Morgan took it off its focus list. And I also note that, you know, UPS has just trounced this. So why is FedEx still better than UPS?
Well, UPS is unionized, and they've got union discussions coming up, number one. And those will have much higher, will be much tougher than going out and hiring people to come in. Number two, FedEx, as you know, they weren't making money on the Amazon arrangement, so they got rid of Amazon. UPS now has Amazon, and that's a low-margin business that's going to take up a lot of their capacity. So I think UPS actually will underperform going forward, and that FedEx is much more in control of their fate in terms of the labor situation, which is critical and will be critical going forward from here as well.
Joe T., Steve Weiss, thank you for calling in. I appreciate that. I know.